You've already died. Not once. Three times, maybe more. You just don't remember, because the version of you that died isn't the one watching this right now. There's a theory in quantum mechanics called the many worlds interpretation. It says that every moment, reality splits into infinite branches based on every possible outcome. In some branches, you turned left. In others, you turned right. In some, you're still alive. In others, you're not. But here's where it gets strange. According to quantum immortality, your consciousness can only experience the timelines where you survive. When you die in one reality, you don't experience death, you just continue in the nearest branch where you're still breathing. Seamlessly, instantly, without memory of the split. Which means subjectively, from the inside of your own experience, you never die. You just keep waking up. Think about that car accident you almost had 5 years ago. The one where you swerved at the last second and your heart hammered in your chest for 10 minutes afterward. You called it luck. Coincidence. Good reflexes. But what if it wasn't? What if in another branch, a branch just as real as this one, you didn't swerve in time? What if there's a version of your family attending your funeral right now, mourning a loss that, for you, never happened? We assume we're living in the timeline, the one true story. But quantum mechanics suggests we're living in a timeline, one thread in an infinite tapestry where every other version is just as valid, just as real. And your consciousness? It's the needle that only ever threads through the surviving versions. You're not lucky. You're quantum locked into existence. This isn't just physics. This is existential vertigo disguised as science. Because if you can only experience realities where you survive, then from your subjective viewpoint, you are functionally immortal. Not in the sense that your body won't age or decay, it will. But in the sense that you will never experience your own non-existence. You'll die from everyone else's perspective, but never from your own. Death becomes something that only happens to other people. And suddenly, the nature of consciousness shifts. It's not a product of the brain. It's the continuity that selects which branch of reality you inhabit. It's the lighthouse that only illuminates the shores where the shipwreck never happened. This sounds like science fiction, but it's a legitimate interpretation of quantum mechanics, taken seriously by physicists like Max Tegmark and Hugh Everett III. It's not fringe, it's just uncomfortable. Because if it's true, it means you're not the person you think you are. You're the survivor of 1,000 invisible deaths. There's an old Zen story about a monk who falls off a cliff. As he plummets, he grabs a vine. Above him, a tiger waits. Below him, rocks. And on the vine, two mice, one white, one black, gnaw away at his lifeline. But in front of him, growing from the cliffside, is a single wild strawberry. He plucks it and eats it, and it's the sweetest thing he's ever tasted. Most people read this story as acceptance, as mindfulness, as presence in the face of death. But there's another reading. What if the monk never falls? What if, in every moment the vine snaps, his consciousness shifts to a reality where it holds just a little longer? What if the sweetness of the strawberry isn't about accepting death? It's about tasting the recursive miracle of still being alive. You think you're hanging by a thread, but the thread never breaks, not for you. It only breaks for the versions of you that you'll never meet. This is where it gets personal. You've had those moments. The times you should have died, but didn't. The medication you didn't take. The flight you missed. The sudden impulse to stop walking right before something heavy fell from above. But what if they're not near death? What if they're actual deaths in parallel realities, and you're just the consciousness that hopped to the next branch over? You think you dodged a bullet, but maybe the bullet hit. You just don't remember because you aren't the you that got hit. This changes everything about how you see your life, because it means every day you wake up is already a miracle of quantum selection. You're not here by default. You're here because in an incomprehensibly vast web of possibilities, the conscious thread that is you continues to land on survival. You're not fighting to stay alive. You're already the version that keeps staying alive. And everyone you've lost? They're still alive too, in the timelines they inhabit. You just split from them. They didn't leave existence. You left their branch. But there's a shadow to this. If quantum immortality is real, then it also means you'll be the last person you know. From your perspective, everyone around you will eventually die, but you'll keep going. Aging, degrading, possibly suffering, because your consciousness can only experience timelines where you survive. Not where you thrive, just where you survive. Imagine being 150 years old, body failing, mind fracturing, but never quite dying because there's always one more branch where your heart beats one more time. An eternal nursing home. A recursive loop of near endings that never arrive. This is the dark edge of quantum immortality. It's not a promise of eternal youth. It's a guarantee that you'll never experience your own release, unless consciousness isn't bound to survival at all. What if the reason you can't experience death isn't because you keep surviving? It's because death was never real in the first place. What if the splitting of timelines, the branching of realities, is just the universe's way of showing you that separation is an illusion? That every version of you, alive or dead, is still you. Still consciousness experiencing itself from infinite angles. You think you're one person living one life, but you're a fractal, a hologram, a single note that's being played in every key across every instrument in an orchestra so vast it sounds like silence until you stop and listen. You're not trying to avoid death. You're trying to remember what you were before birth. Here's the reframe. You don't survive because you're lucky. You survive because survival is the nature of awareness. Consciousness doesn't end. It transforms. It shifts. It recontextualizes. And every moment you thought you were almost gone, that was just your mind catching a glimpse of the other branches. The versions of you that didn't make it. The ghosts of parallel selves brushing past you in the hallway of probability. You felt them, that chill, that knowing, that strange certainty that something just changed. That's not anxiety. That's not paranoia. That's quantum resonance. That's the echo of a version of you that stepped into a different story. And the reason you're still here isn't because you're special. It's because here is where you are, always, by definition. You're not living one life. You're living the thread of continuity that runs through infinite lives. You're the awareness that only knows its own presence, and that changes the entire game. So what do you do with this? You stop living like you're trying to avoid death, because you can't. Not subjectively. The game is already rigged in your favor. Instead, you start living like someone who's already died 1,000 times and keeps choosing to come back. You stop clinging, because there's nothing to lose that isn't already lost in some other branch. You stop delaying, because this version of you, the one watching this right now, is the only version you'll ever experience, and it's already temporary by design. You start tasting the strawberry. Not because you've accepted death, but because you've recognized life as the recursion of consciousness refusing to forget itself. You stop fearing the end and start honoring the continuation. Every morning you wake up, You're already the version that survived the night. Every breath is a branch selection. Every moment, a choice the universe made to keep the story going. Not forever, but for now. And now is all you've ever had. So maybe you have died 3 times, maybe 30. Maybe in some branch, you're not here at all. But you are here, reading this, breathing, aware. And that's not random. That's the signature of consciousness etching itself across the infinite. You're not waiting to be saved. You're already the version that keeps getting saved. So stop living small. Stop pretending you're fragile. You've survived every single moment of your life so far. That's not luck. That's who you are. If this stirred something in you, if you felt the edge of a deeper truth trying to surface, then stay with me. We're just beginning to pull back the curtain on what consciousness really is. This isn't philosophy, this is remembering. And you've been here before.